In this tutorial, we're going to take a look at how to obtain means for different groups of a variable on some other variable of interest. Let me show you what I mean here. So, for example, in this data set, we have two variables, play golf and satisfaction. Now, play golf is coded. If I click on my value labels button here, I've already coded it. And you can see that we have either yes, those who do play golf, or no, those who do not play golf. Now, when I said I wanted to obtain means for the different groups, what I want is I want to get a mean on satisfaction, this variable, for golfers, for those who answer yes to playing golf, I want a mean for this group alone, and then I want a mean for the no group as well. Okay, and this variable satisfaction, higher scores indicate greater satisfaction, and these are seven people who lived in a community in which there was a golf course on it. So five of the people who lived in the community who answered yes, they're golfers, and the two who answered no, they are not golfers. Okay, so once again, I want satisfaction, a mean satisfaction level, separately for the yes group and one for the no group. I want it separated. And this is often an area of confusion in SPSS, how to do this. Let's go ahead and proceed with perhaps a normal route of trying to figure this out. Go to Analyze, Descriptive Statistics, Descriptives, and we're going to see what happens if we just go ahead and do an analysis directly on satisfaction. Okay, so I'm going to move satisfaction over, go to Options, and then I want the mean, and let's get the standard deviation as well for this lesson. So I'll deselect minimum and maximum. Click Continue and click OK. Our output or viewer window opens, and notice here in our descriptive statistics, recall that I said that I wanted means separately for the yes group and the no group. But if you notice this output here, I have satisfaction, all seven people are included, and I have just one overall mean of 7.86. So this actually didn't give me means for the different groups. I don't have a mean for the yes and a mean for the no groups. I just have an overall mean. So this actually didn't do what I wanted. So let's go try again. Let's click on this little star here. This will take you straight to the data. And once again, I want a mean for just the yes group, the ones, and a mean for just the two, the no's. And I wanted to show you the descriptives way just to show you that it's not actually correct and why it's not. So now we know what we want. We want it separate. We want the means broken down separately by the different groups. To do that, we need to go to Analyze, Compare Means, Means. Okay, so select that. And then here in our dependent list, this is where the satisfaction variable would go. So move that over. And the independent list will always be the categorical variable. In this case, the variable play golf, it's categorical, and it happens to be dichotomous because there are only two options, a one or a two, or a yes or a no. Okay, so play golf will go to the independent list. And then go to options so we can see what options are selected. Okay, I see a mean and I see a standard deviation by default and number of cases as well. We can keep number of cases. That could be helpful. But let's drag that up to the top here and have that present first in our output. Okay, so we have everything looks good here. Let's click continue and then click OK. Now our output opens. We're going to scroll down here. Actually, I'm going to delete a little bit of this. I'll delete this by selecting it, pressing the delete key. I'm going to delete this here so we can see these two tables at the same time. Here's the output of my means procedure, the procedure we just ran. I'm just going to briefly mention this case processing summary table just to say it shows that all seven observations were included and none were excluded. So everything was analyzed. That's all that means. Okay, but zeroing in on this table, the report table, this is what we want to see. Notice here, I have the play golf variable, and I have analyses for the yes group, the 5 people who are in the yes group, and the no group, the 2 people in that group. And notice now I have means broken down separately for these 2 groups, which is exactly what I wanted. So the yes group, those who play golf, had an average satisfaction score of 8.2, whereas those who did not play golf had an average satisfaction score of 7. So you should be able to see, at least in the sample here, that those who played golf did have a higher average satisfaction score, or a higher mean satisfaction score, than those who did not play golf. Okay, and we see the standard deviations here as well. Just as a side note, this standard deviation is 0 because our 2 people who were in the no group both had a score of 7. If they both have a score of 7, there's no variability at all in the data set for this group. So that's why we have a standard deviation of 0. Okay, one last note here. Notice the total. You see where it says 7 here, and then we have a mean of 7.86, standard deviation of 0.90. If we go back up here to our original analysis, the analysis using descriptive statistics and then using the descriptives option, notice we have the same thing, 7.86 for the mean, 0.9 for the standard deviation. So what the means procedure does down here, it breaks it down by the different groups, and it also gives you the overall analysis down here, which is what we got the first time by descriptive statistics. But anytime you want to get a descriptive analysis, but of means separately for different groups, you want to go to analyze, compare means, and then the means procedure. Now, if you're doing inferential analyses, like a two-way ANOVA, for example, you can get that within the two-way ANOVA procedure. But if we're just doing simple descriptive statistics, no inferential testing, and we just want to see means here by different groups, then you want to use analyze, compare means, means. This concludes the tutorial on using the means procedure in SPSS.